guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video here, we'll be working here on a Dodge 3.6 engine, guys. So that's a Dodge Chrysler Jeep engine, 3.6 Pentastar engine. They use it on Charger, Challenger, Dodge Journey, Chrysler 200, 300. You'll find it on Jeep Wrangler, guys. That's a very, very popular engine. And in today's video, guys, we're going to show you how to bleed the cooling system on that thing. So stay with us, and that's what we'll be covering. So on this engine, guys, we have more than 200 videos taking the whole engine apart, torque specs, anything like that. So please, guys, subscribe to the channel if you need help with anything. Now, right here, this is your coolant overflow bottle. We need to remove the cap, okay, for the coolant reservoir. Now, this is a bleeder valve on the thermostat housing. So we need to take this one loose, and then we'll start adding coolant. Okay, so we're going to get that thermostat screw loose. Perfect, just like that. So we'll start adding coolant now, guys. Okay, we'll slowly start adding coolant. That's already pre-mixed coolant. You can see where we get ours from in the description of the video below. While we're adding coolant, we're going to keep eye on the screw that we removed and make sure that we don't have coolant coming out. We'll start seeing coolant coming out, so you have to put a container to catch the coolant that's going to leak out, so you don't make a mess underneath the engine. And when you stop seeing air bubbles for about a minute, probably slowly adding coolant, I will put the screw in. That's how we usually do it. So we'll grab a little bit more coolant and we'll continue. Okay, let us show you now. It just started leaking out. Okay, and we don't see any air. So we're gonna catch some of the coolant out. But we don't see any air coming out, so that's a good thing. We're going to go ahead, place the screw now. The bleeder screw. Okay, and it's still leaking a little bit even when you catch it, so that's fine. Even if you have some air, it's going to come out. And we're going to get this one tight now. Yeah, okay, perfect. So this is the radiator cap, guys. Now right here you can see a little bit of crack, so you always have to inspect yours. If it started cracking, it's time to replace it, because those seals will eventually go bad and your car can overheat because of a bad radiator cap. So we'll just need to add a little bit more coolant to reach to the cold maximum line there. Okay, that's it, right there. Next, we need to install our radiator cap on, get it tight all the way. Okay, like that. Next, you need to, for next procedure, you need to get your car out of the shop. Do not ever start the car inside the shop and let it run, because you can die. So we have that one reader now, 3008. That's very affordable scanner, guys. We're going to watch live to make sure that the car doesn't overheat while we're keeping eye on the temperature, on the coolant temperature, because it's important not to overheat those engines. Next, we're going to go ahead and start the car. Okay, I'll start it like that. And we're going to make sure, okay, let me turn now the climate on. We need to wait a little bit of time. Okay, let me turn the light so you can see. Okay, we accept climate. So we need to turn, okay, the temperature up. Okay, temperature up on left and right side. Okay, all the way up. If you have the climate control, and the fan needs to be all the way on high like that. Next, we're going to go under diagnose. It's going to connect now, and okay, let me see if it's better without the light. Yep. We need to go ahead, click OK. We're going to go to data streaming here, and under data streaming, we'll see view all items supported. Okay, and this one right here, it says coolant temperature right now, 84, 86, you can see it's climbing 87. At 230, I believe the fan will turn on. That's what our ECU is set at. So we need to make sure that it doesn't overheat past that point. Now, do that only in the open, do not do it in your garage. So we can see we have the LCD display here that displays the coolant temperature, so that's a big advantage here, but we have the temperature gauge as well. Make sure that it doesn't overheat past half of it, and we're going to let it idle for about 5 to 10 minutes and keep eye on it. If it starts overheating, then turn the car off. If you have the third row or rear controls for the heat, okay, turn them all the way on high with the fan on high as well, because the heater core for the rear is usually located back there, so you want to make sure that the coolant circulates through there as well. Okay, next guys, when you reach half right here on the gauge, on your temperature gauge, which ours is about 190, 200 degrees almost, we're going to rev the car between 2 and 3000 RPMs. That's how you do it for this 3.6 engine, and keep it there between 2 and 3000 RPMs for 2 to 3 minutes. Okay, like that. And that way we'll get some air pockets out of the system if we have any air pockets. We're not going to video the whole thing, guys. No need to see me revving the car for 2 minutes. But that's what we'll be doing, and we'll show you what needs to be done next. So, right now, guys, it's been about 2-3 minutes. I revved it up. The engine is not overheating. It's in the middle. Everything's good. We have really good heater on the front, okay? Heater works really good. Air is really hot coming out. If you have the third row seating, make sure that the vents, you get hot air out of them as well. That way you'll make sure that you don't have air pockets. In the meantime, we need to do something else. Next, we'll turn the car off. Okay guys, so now we're out of the car. The coolant is extremely hot. Never ever open the overflow bottle, okay, right now, because if you do, that thing will severely burn. I mean, it's hot. Right now it's almost 230 degrees. But you can see the level. It went down. It was all the way up here, now it's down here. So we're going to let the car sit overnight for about 10 to 12 hours. Everything will be cold. We're going to add more coolant. Now what is happening? There is pressure in the system. And if you have an air pocket, that air pocket will be replaced with coolant while the car is cooling down. Later, fill it up to the max when it's cold. Okay, drive it short distance, keep eye on the temperature gauge, make sure everything's good, and you should be ready to go. So thank you for watching, see you guys next time.